Gaines, he keeps it in the zone around the boards. Set to the blue line. McCloskey fires it one in. Not through traffic. Gungolski with a shot here. Scores for the Dundee Stars. Igor Gungolski takes the pass there right in the middle of the defensive zone for the Steelers and fires it into the back of the net with only 1 minute and 22 seconds on the clock. It's Dundee Stars 1, Sheffield Steelers 0.
Well, we said shocks and surprises do happen, and that was a fantastic bit of play by Dundee Stars. Igor Gungolski scoring his 10th goal of the season, and wasn't that one that was very vital to the Dundee Stars indeed?
Well, I might have just upset the Steelers, and the backlash might well be on the way very soon. Spend the board for Mosienko. In the middle, the return pass is not quite completed, and a scrap in the front of the goal, it's Gungolski. And a shove and match in shoes for Gungolski and Roy going at it. And they're still going while the refs are in there as well. That's Dowd, sorry, not Roy, I think. Well, Gungolski trying to stamp his authority on this game early on with Robert Dowd. And both head to the penalty boxes, having had a bit of a workout.
Well, that's maybe a sign of things to come tonight, yeah?
Yep. Yeah, the Sheffield Steelers and Dundee Stars games have got a habit of doing this, don't they? Ringrose picks up the loose puck, finds Lust. Lust moves up the centre, takes it across the line, moves out to the right-hand corner. Round the board for Ringrose. Back in front for Quick. Quick shoots and scores! Kevin Quick took the pass from Lust there, all alone, in front of Doyle. And would you believe it, it's 2-0 Dundee Stars with 18 minutes and 1 second to go in the second period.
Yeah, but we all know Kevin Quick, the D-man, has a little bit of skill going forward up front, and that is his fourth goal of the season. And wow, isn't that an important one from a Dundee Stars perspective?
Well, Kevin Quick, the defenceman who's filling in up front for Dundee Stars this evening due to the injuries, has scored a second goal of the night for Dundee. Round the boards, and their first is Forney. Finds Roy behind the net, in front, chance, scores for the Steelers! Took the pass in front there all the way around the goal, and that is Jeff Legui scoring for the Sheffield Steelers. He did it the last time and he's done it again. It's Dundee Stars 2, Sheffield Steelers 1, with 9 minutes and 16 seconds left in the second period.
Well, we did say one goal back for the Sheffield Steelers. Pulls them right into this game, and that goal from Legui, his third of the season, really makes a difference now. It's now game on.
Yep. Well, once the linesman is happy, we'll have a face-off just outside the Steelers' offensive zone. There we go. Puck drops. And Roy shoots, and a good glove save by Chevrolet there. Hint of offside there.
Well, Jeff, what have you made so far for the Stars?
Well, it's good. I think we're sticking to a system, and we're frustrating them, and we got a couple goals early. So I think more of the same in the third. You know, if we stay tight and stay together and play as a unit, even though we're short, we can persevere. And I think we can get something out of this game.
Well, best of luck, Jeff. Thanks for talking to us.
All right, thank you.
That's cleared away. Grimshaw not able to put that one down. He's letting Hill here. Chance here for Hill. Shoots, and Chevrolet saves. Well, almost a short-handed goal for Sheffield there. Swindlehurst feeds Gungolski. Oh, good defensive play there again. And it's Kevin Quick in front. Oh, Doyle's scrambled that one and makes a save. It's Ringrose eventually knocks it away. But Dowd plays it back in for Mosienko into the final 3 minutes of this game. Grimshaw on the boards, trying to get it back. The Steelers pull the puck in. Chance, Chevrolet makes a save, it's rebounded. And again, it's kept in the zone by Hay. fired in, chance in front, that one's loose, chance, scores for the Sheffield Steelers. The scoring equaliser with 2 minutes and 29 seconds to go in the game. Mark Chevery on the floor, not moving. Some argument that the goal was off the Mooners before that crossed the line, but that one is for the replay. But at the moment, it is Dundee Stars 2, Sheffield Steelers 2, with 2:29 to go in the game.
Yeah, with the firepower they've got, Sheffield Steelers, you can never count them out, especially when it's only 2-1 to Dundee Stars, and they've managed to pull that equaliser. Will they now be feeling they can go on and get the winner with 2:29 left of the third period?
Entirely possible. Saric forward for Mosienko. Mosienko across the line. Chance here in the face-off circle. Oh, and he's pulled it backwards. And a chance here for Gungolski. O'Connor's on his own. Gungolski across the line for the Stars. Pass it across the ice. Is intercepted by the stick of O'Connor. And it's possession back to Sheffield. And a chance now. Chance in front. Shoots. Chevery saves. Hutchins, I think, will take a penalty there, and that is a penalty shot. Hutchins with some desperate defending. And that is a penalty shot to the Sheffield Steelers with 3 minutes and 20 seconds to go in overtime. Well, if it wasn't tense before, it certainly is now. Jonathan Phillips against Mark Chevery to win the game for the Steelers. Here he goes, down the centre. Chevery, out his goal. Phillips, down the centre still. Chevery makes a save. And we continue in overtime, 3 minutes and 20 to go. Here goes Dowd, moves out to the left-hand side, back into the centre. Misses! Chevery might have got a tip on that one, but either way, it's not in the goal. And not the best of starts for Sheffield. Frank Doyle then, in goal now for Sheffield. And here goes Sean Ringrose for the Dundee Stars. Ringrose down the centre, Doyle out his goal. Ringrose scores for the Dundee Stars, and his advantage Dundee after the first round of penalty shots. Ringrose has a habit of scoring these penalty shots for his team. Mosienko to equalise things for the Steelers. Here he goes, moves out to the right hand side. Chevery right out his goal, Mosienko. Chevery sticks a pad out and stops that one crossing the line. No way through for Tyler Mosienko. Advantage Dundee Stars. Shane Lust, the next penalty shot taker for Dundee. His second game back after a month out through injury. Here he goes now, moves out to the right hand side. Doyle right out the goal. Lust closes down, shoots and misses a target over the shoulder of Frank Doyle. And Steelers get another chance. Chevery with it all to do again for Dundee. Here goes Mike Forney for the Steelers into the zone. And Chevery saves! No way through for Sheffield on the penalty shots this evening. And Dundee Stars take the second point. Sheffield will go home with only a point, as did Belfast Giants last week. And the second penalty shot win for the Dundee Stars in a fortnight. It's unbelievable stuff at the Dundee Ice Arena tonight on this live Dundee Stars webcast. There's no way I would have had money on the Stars winning this game tonight, to be perfectly honest, given the form of the Steelers and the Stars. But there you go, that's why we love this game, ice hockey. It is brilliant, and it is 3-2 the final score after penalty shots.
Well, Jeff, you must be thoroughly delighted with that one tonight.
Absolutely. I think everyone bought into what we were trying to achieve tonight. And, you know, I said to the guys, if we get something out of every weekend, we're going to make the playoffs. And just goes to show the character of the guys. We had 11 skaters tonight. And, you know, Martin Single coming back early from injury just so that we had an extra body. I can't say enough about the guys. You know, we've faced some heavy defeats, but it's not from a lack of trying. And I think, you know, tonight just shows that, you know, there's going to be nights when we try our best and it's not good enough. But then there's tonight where, you know, everyone believed and we pulled off a huge win against a very good team.
Yeah, I mean, I must like you even more, like you say, with the short numbers you have available game in, game up.
Yeah, absolutely. But, you know, I think everyone's bought into the system. We're playing while we're short. And, you know, again, it's a process and, you know, we're learning the system and it's only been, you know, about 3-4 weeks. And, you know, some nights we execute it perfectly and some nights, you know, there's holes in our game. But tonight was one of those nights where we, for the most part, played it to a T.
And that playoff spot must be something that people even who weren't believing in it certainly must be now with your team.
I certainly think. I think it's been achievable all year. I think it's, you know, there's a lot of season left. There still is a lot of season left. And, you know, we're just going to concentrate and focus on us moving forward and just see if we can get points out of every weekend.
Well, congratulations, Jeff. Thanks for talking to us.
Thanks a lot.